So good morning everybody, my name is C.S. Srinivas, Associate Professor in PPE Department, St. Martin's Engineering College. So today we will discuss about the transformers. So transformer is a static electrical device which transfers electrical energy from one circuit to the other circuit without change of frequency and power, but with the change of voltage and current. Okay, so this is the transformer diagram. This is the transformer diagram. So supply voltage is given so that the current I1 is going to the primary winding. So we are connecting load to the secondary winding. So current I2 is going here. So the temperature voltage is V2 and supply voltage is V1. So that the level of turns on the primary is A1. So that the initial of V1 is E1. So phi is phi of flux going to the transformer core. And E2 is the secondary induced EMF and N2 is the number of turns in the second. Okay, so this is the transformer diagram. So what is the working principle? So it works the working principle. So it works on the principle of mutual inductance. So working principle. So it works on the principle of mutual inductance. So which states that so the rate of so the induced EMF is proportional to the rate of change of flux. So E is proportional to d phi by dt. E is proportional to d phi by dt. So if you are taking primary side, so E1 is equal to minus N1 into d phi by dt. So this is equation number 1. So here N1 is the number of turns in the primary and d phi by dt is the rate of change of flux. So in the similar manner, in the secondary side, E2 is equal to minus N2 into d phi by dt. So this is equation number 2. Where N2 is the number of turns in the secondary and E2 is the secondary induced EMF and d phi by dt is the rate of change of flux. So here the theory. So when we are applying the voltage V1, when we are applying the voltage V1 to the primary winding, so this is nothing but the primary winding. So primary winding. So this is secondary winding. So when we are applying the voltage given to the primary winding, so that an alternating current I1 is flowing to the primary winding. So due to flowing of current, flux is produced. That flux flowing to the transformer core. So this produced flux cut by both primary winding as well as secondary winding. So due to cutting of flux, so that an EMF will be induced in the primary as well as secondary. So the primary induced EMF is E1 and the secondary induced EMF is E2. So here E1 is the primary induced EMF and E2 is the primary explained. So the induced EMF is proportional to the rate of change of flux. So E1 is proportional to minus N1 into d phi by dt. So here minus indicates the opposite direction. So here E2 is equal to minus N2 into d phi by dt. Now from the equations 1 and 2, divide equation 2 by 1. So divide equation 2 by 1. So this is equal to E2 by E1 is equal to N2 by N1. So this is equal to K. This is equal to K. K is called the voltage transmission ratio. K is known as or called as voltage transmission ratio. So from the K also, we can say that the transformer is step up. So before that, we can. So transformers are of two types. So according to voltage wise, transformers are classified into two types. So first one is step up transformer, and second one is step down transformer. So first we will discuss about the step up transformer. What is step up transformer? Yes, the output voltage. Here the output voltage is V2, the input voltage is V1. So from the name itself we can understand step up transformer. So the output voltage is more than the input voltage. So from this one, step up voltage, the output voltage V2 is more than V1. Is known as step up transformer. So we can say that N2, the number of So either b2 is greater than b1 or m2 is greater than m1. So that we can say that the transformer is step up transformer. From the chaos of, we can conclude that so if k is greater than 1, the transformer is step up transformer. So from this we can understand. So if k is greater than 1 means n2 is greater than n1. N2 is greater than n1 or e2 is greater than e1. So we know that if e2 is proportional to v2 and v1 is proportional to v1. So from this we can write that. So here e2 by e1 is equal to n2 by n1 is equal to. So we can write that. So here v2 by v1 also. So v2 by v1 is equal to e2 by e1 is equal to m2 by m1. Sorry, m2 by n1 is equal to k. Now, so one more case. So we know that what is the transformer definition? Transformer is a static electrical device which transfers electrical energy from one side to the other without change of power. But what is the power? So we understand that. So power p1 must be equal to p2. We assume that the power p1 is the primary side power and p2 is the secondary side power. So for example, so here you know the formula p1 is equal to v1 i1 must be equal to v2 i2. So from this, so v2 by v1, v2 by v1 is equal to i1 by i2. So using this relation we can write as here, so v2 by v1 is equal to i1 by, so i1 by i2 is equal to v2 by v1 is equal to e2 by e1 is equal to n2 by n1 is equal to k, where k is called voltage transmission ratio, where k is called voltage transmission ratio. So that, so I1 by N2, these are the relations in different form. So that this is the current relation, voltage relation, which linear relation and number of terms relation. So now from this also we can identify the, from the k value also we can identify the transformer, which transformer it is, either it is step up transformer or step down transformer. Now come to here. So step up transformer, so here the number of terms in the secondary is greater than number of terms in the primary, or the secondary voltage is more than the primary voltage. So then the transformer is called voltage transmission ratio. Okay. So now come to the step down transformer. The name is step. So this is nothing but the vice versa to the first one. Vice versa to the step up transformer. So here step down transformer means the number of terms in the secondary is less than the number of terms in the primary. So N2 is less than N1 and V2. Sorry, V2 is less than V1. V2 is less than V1. Then the transformer is called step down transformer. So third one is if N2 is equal to N1, if N2 is equal to N1 or V2 is equal to V1, so then the transformer is called 1 to 1 transformer or isolation transformer. 1 to 1 transformer and isolation. So from the K also we can identify the, so which transformer it is, which transformer it is. Okay. So next one is so the main parts of the transformer or construction of the transformer. Yeah. So main parts of the mainly the transformer consisting of two parts. So transformer core. So transformer core and second one is transformer windings. Transformer windings. Again, the transformer windings are classified into two types. So primary winding. So primary winding and secondary winding. Yeah. So now first we will discuss about the transformer core. So the rectangular portion of a transformer, this one, the rectangular portion of a transformer is called transformer core. Transformer core. So here the horizontal portion, these two is called the yokes. These two is called the, and the bottom and top portion is called yokes. The vertical portion, so these two portions is called the limbs. These two is called the limbs. So the top and bottom portion of a transformer is known as yokes. So the vertical portion, these two portions are called limbs. This is the construction of transformer core. The next one is Second one is the main part of the binding. So here, transformer binds are just going to be two types of primary binding and secondary binding. So this is nothing but the primary binding, this one nothing but the secondary binding. Now, what is primary binding? The winding which is connected to the supply. The winding which is connected to the supply is known as primary binding. The winding which is connected to the load. The winding which is connected to the load is known as secondary winding. The winding which is connected. So here these are the members. So, primary winding and secondary winding. The winding which is connected to the supply is known as primary winding. The winding which is connected to the load is known as secondary winding. So this is the main parts of the transformer. Next. So before we have to discuss, so according to voltage wise, the transformers are classified into two types, step up and step down. Now, according to construction wise, the transformers are classified into two types, shell type transformer and core type transformer. Shell type transformer and second one is core type transformer. Okay. So according to construction wise, the transformers are again classified into two types, shell type transformer and core type transformer. So now first we will discuss about the shell type transformer. So this is the first one, the shell type. So this is the spectrum diagram of shell type transformer. Yeah. So this is also in rectangular shape. This is also in rectangular shape. But in this, so two magnetic segments are present. So this is one magnetic segment. This is second magnetic. So here we are having three limbs. So first limb, and middle limb, and last limb. So in this shell type transformer, so the both the primary and this is primary winding. So already we discussed what is primary winding. The winding which is connected to the supply known as primary winding. The winding which is connected to the load is called as secondary winding. So in this shell type transformer case, both primary as well as secondary windings are bound on the middle limb. Okay. So here we are having two magnetic segments. Total flux is divided into two fluxes, phi 2 by 5 by 2. So total phi 2 by 2 is 5. So total magnetic flux is divided into two segments. So this is two magnetic segments. This is one magnetic segment and this is another magnetic segment. So this is applicable for low voltage high current purpose. This is applicable to low voltage high current. The next one is four type transformer. So this transformer is called four type transformer. So in this transformer, so the primary winding is wound on the first limb and secondary winding is wound on the second limb. But in this case both the primary as well as secondary windings are wound on the middle limb. Okay, so this is the four type transformer. This is also in rectangular shape. This is also a rectangular shape. So only single magnetic circuit is present. But in case of shell type transformer, we have two magnetic circuits is present. So total flux is divided into two halves, 5 by 2 and 5 by 2. But here only single magnetic circuit, that is 5. So the primary winding is wound on the first limb and secondary winding is wound on the second limb. This is the classification of transformer under the construction. Okay. So now EMF equation. Next very important topic in the transformer is EMF equation. So this is a flux waveform. So from the waveform we can conclude that so the flux waveform is starting from 0 and reaches to maximum in 1/4 of the time period. So therefore, the average rate of change of flux is equal to so phi m by t by 4, this is equal to 4 phi m by t. This I can write 4 2πmf. Where pi because 1 by 2 r. Reciprocal of time under the word frequency. Reciprocal of time under the word frequency. But in case of sinusoidal wave, the form factor is equal to RMS value by average value. In sine wave, the value is fixed, that is 1.11. The value is fixed, that is 1.11. So from this we can write, so RMS value is equal to 1.11 into average value. 1.11 into average value. So this is nothing but the, so average value, the rate of change of mass, so this is nothing but the average induced EMF. Average induced EMF is equal to 4πmf. So the RMS value of induced EMF, the RMS value of induced EMF is equal to, that is equal to, so that value. So 1.11 into 4πmf. This is equal to 4.445mf. So now, if you take primary side, the RMS value of induced EMF at the primary side, E1 is equal to 4.445mfn1. So this is the EMF equation in case of primary side. So what are the units for EMF? Volts. In the similar manner, the secondary induced EMF E2 is equal to 4.445mfn2. We consider the secondary terms, that is, N2 is the secondary number of terms. So, volts. So this is very important information. Thank you.